Hello, LA Daily Finance, and welcome to today's video where we're going to be talking about wind energy and the industry surrounding it. Let's dive in. We all know how wind energy works, right? You guessed it, an army of airbenders. No, so what actually happens is, wind turbines use the kinetic energy of wind to make the blades turn, which is the mechanical energy necessary to turn a generator, producing electricity. Wind energy works well with solar because it's often windier once the sun has set and warm air rises. Easy enough, right? Well, the difficult part comes in deciding where to place them. There are, of course, naturally windy areas all around the world, but even in an area with wind blowing 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, for a full year, we still would not be able to collect the full energy of the wind. This is in part because our technology does not have a 100% conversion rate, but also because of something called the Betz Limit, which explains that the maximum amount of kinetic energy we'd be able to extract from wind is around 59%. The actual mechanical power received through the generator is less, as energy is lost due to friction and technological inefficiencies. So, our current wind turbines operate at around 40% efficiency, which is close to the theoretical real-world maximum of about 45%. That's more than twice as efficient as me making these videos. The other issue is that a lot of really windy places are also really remote. So on top of building the wind energy infrastructure, we also have to build a system to get the electricity from where it's collected to where it's going to be used. Even though these disadvantages exist, wind energy use has more than tripled in the last decade. The fact is, it provides clean energy and creates jobs. Around 8% of the US's energy generating capacity comes from wind turbines, the country's fourth largest source. The third largest source, of course, being people's frustration when they can't get wind energy. There are over 50,000 wind turbines across the country, and by 2050, it's estimated that wind energy will power over 60 million homes. It is the topmost used renewable energy source in the country, and it's still growing. In 2020, the US installed more wind turbine capacity than in any other year. A part of the US Department of Energy called Wind Energy Technologies Office helps fund early stage research and development to improve our technological advancement in this field. And in early 2021, the Energy Department announced funding of up to $14.5 million for offshore wind environmental research. The federal government, along with the Department of Energy, are helping to promote the development of wind energy infrastructure with grants, tax incentives, or financial aid. The Department of Energy announced that General Electric's research field would receive $20.3 million to build and test a state-of-the-art generator on a wind turbine. Since 2012, the National Renewable Energy Laboratory has awarded 44 subcontracts to 23 different companies, totaling over $10 million. As part of its goal to be carbon-free by 2045, California is going to create two offshore wind farms. The Bureau of Ocean Energy Management will be leasing federal offshore land for the purpose of creating floating wind farms. Keeping in mind California's commitment to renewables, these offshore wind farms will be very useful. And, according to the Office of Governor Gavin Newsom, they will also create thousands of jobs and provide energy to over a million homes. This is the projected growth of the wind industry in the US. So it's undeniable that wind energy production will keep growing. The global market value of the industry in 2020 was around $125 billion, and it's projected to hit $180 billion by 2027. Countries around the world are developing on and offshore wind farms. In the US, companies like Duke Energy, which trades under ticker DUK, US Wind, NextEra Energy, ticker NEE, and in California specifically, TerraGen, Oak Creek Energy, Clearway Energy Inc., ticker CWEN, are developing or helping in the development of wind farms all across the country and abroad. Duke Energy has developed over 20 wind energy projects and invested over $4 billion in the wind industry. The California company TerraGen developed the Alto Wind Energy Center, located near Tehachapi, California, and it is the largest wind farm in the United States. Originally, TerraGen purchased the project from an Australian company for $325 million. The rest of the project, however, which cost around $2.8 billion, was funded through financing, investments from banks, Google, and federal tax credits and grants. Oak Creek Energy has developed a few projects in California, but now has also expanded into Latin America, with its first two projects in Mexico totaling approximately $400 million. So for people or companies that may be looking to invest or innovate in this field, what does the future of wind technologies look like? Well, currently, engineers are trying to figure out a way to create airborne, i.e. floating, wind turbines that could take advantage of winds high up in the air, while others are considering artificial wind harvesting trees. Perhaps someone can create a solar paneled wind turbine that is able to capture both forms of energy. Kind of like a Swiss Army knife of renewable energy, if you will. But regardless, the market is still highly competitive with lots of room for growth. And with a global push towards renewable and plans set in motion to increase wind energy capacity in the US, it seems like the perfect time to be a part of this industry. I'm Alejandro Rossi of LA Daily Finance. Thank you so much for watching. Like, share, subscribe, and I will see you next time.